In 1973, a Chinese scientist named Yuan Longping cultivated the world's first indica hybrid rice. After decades of development and improvement, the yield of the super rice has increased from more than 200 kilograms per mu to 1,100 kilograms. This is the data as of 2023. But China has not used the super rice technology alone. Instead, it has promoted it to poorer and backward African countries to help more people escape hunger. In Burundi, a humble country in Central Africa, nearly 70 Chinese agricultural experts work closely with local farmers to grow this miraculous super rice. After 12 years of unremitting efforts, they successfully increased Burundi's rice production from 3 tons to 10 tons per hectare, setting a record for the highest rice production in Africa's history. What's more worth mentioning is that this super rice has also lifted about 300,000 residents of Burundi out of hunger and poverty. But China's good deed was not appreciated by everyone. Some media have raised questions about China's super rice. They believe that this genetically modified rice may contain toxins and that large-scale planting will cause immeasurable damage to Burundi's natural environment. So, what exactly has China done for Burundi in the past 12 years? I think the final answer will shock you. If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. In 2023, Burundi was ranked as one of the poorest countries in the world, ranking 4th. The per capita GDP here is only $300, and agriculture has become the main pillar of the national economy, accounting for more than 40% of the total economic output value. Although Burundi has more than 1.3 million hectares of land suitable for farming, the shadow of famine and death always lingers above their heads. Statistics show that the poverty rate in Burundi is as high as 70%, and about 30% of areas face food shortages. In this land, poverty and hunger have threatened countless lives for decades, and even one in every 5 children dies due to hunger or malnutrition. Although agriculture is the core pillar of Burundi's economy, local farmers generally rely on traditional farming methods. The lack of modern agricultural technology and tools results in inefficient output and meager returns. What's even more serious is that due to a shortage of funds, many farmers are often unable to purchase seeds, fertilizers, and herbicides, which further weakens their planting efficiency. According to data from the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, the global average rice yield per mu in 2023 is about 680 kilograms, while Burundi's yield per mu is only 230 kilograms. Such production is at a low level globally, and for a country with a population of more than 12 million, it is far from meeting the basic food needs of its people. Although Western countries have provided a large amount of economic and medical assistance to Burundi in the past few decades, this assistance has not fundamentally improved their living conditions. Under this situation, how to apply scientific planting methods to improve Burundi's food self-sufficiency level has become a question that urgently needs to be answered. Fortunately, since 2009, China has begun to provide food planting support to Burundi, giving this country that has been on the verge of starvation for a long time a glimmer of hope. In 2009, Beijing, China, held a summit on cooperation with African countries. At the summit, Burundian leaders signed a 20-year agricultural aid plan with China. In order to implement the plan as soon as possible, China began to dispatch more than 70 agricultural technical experts to Burundi in August 2009. The assistance projects they brought to Burundi mainly cover rice, agricultural products, aquaculture, and other fields, among which rice planting is regarded as the most critical link. After preliminary research, Chinese agricultural experts found that Burundi has abundant water resources and sufficient sunshine, which are good conditions for growing rice. However, due to the backward technical level of the local area, the yield of rice is far from ideal, and it is not popular in the local area. Based on these findings, the Chinese expert team decided to conduct the first trial planting of hybrid rice in Burundi's Ling 4 villages. Initially, Chinese agricultural experts carefully selected 7 different varieties of hybrid rice and established 12 large farmlands in the Ling 4 villages for testing. Although there are mature cultivation techniques and specifications for these rice in China, it is obviously not feasible to directly apply these specifications due to the differences in climate conditions between Burundi and China. This means that technicians must adjust and adapt the entire rice cultivation technology system. But at the time, China's rice aid plan was not optimistic because Burundi had received aid from too many countries in the past few decades. Therefore, many people suspect that Chinese agricultural experts, like experts from other countries, are simply unable to grow food on this land. However, the results of the first phase of trial planting by the Chinese expert team greatly exceeded local expectations. In this experiment, the yield of hybrid rice they developed was 5 to 6 times higher than the original yield, setting a new record in Africa. This achievement triggered a huge response in the local area, and many farmers marveled at the magic-like change. As far as I know, in 2023, a total of 380 hectares of super rice were planted in the 4 Ling villages, and the total output successfully exceeded 4,000 tons. Subsequently, Chinese agricultural experts also began to establish more than 1,000 hectares of rice demonstration fields in more areas and trained more than 10,000 local agricultural technicians and farmers. Through the introduction and demonstration of 16 new varieties, the demonstration area of hybrid rice reached 8,950 acres, and the yield reached 6.2 million kilograms of rice. These super rices have almost helped more than 300,000 people escape hunger. In order to encourage more Burundian farmers to devote themselves to rice cultivation, the Chinese government and the local government have jointly established a hybrid rice demonstration production fund. The main goal of this fund is to provide farmers with various resources needed to grow rice, including seeds, fertilizers, herbicides, etc., and also provide on-site technical support from experts. This strategy not only results in improved harvests during the current season, but also promotes a sustainable farming model by allowing farmers to use their earnings to pay back the fund. With more than a decade of aid, Burundi's rice production has reached an all-time high. According to data from Burundi's Ministry of Agriculture, the country's average rice yield per mu has reached 700 kilograms in 2022, and the yield per mu in some experimental fields is as high as 920 kilograms, which is 2 to 3 times the average yield of local rice varieties. This achievement has brought unprecedented hope to Burundi and has lifted more people out of hunger. As of March 2023, Burundi has established 36 hybrid rice demonstration villages, covering 14 provinces, and the hybrid rice planting area has exceeded 60,000 acres. Compared with 2020, China's super rice production has also increased by 15,000 tons, with the output increasing from 3 tons to 10 tons per hectare. This has not only allowed many African families to solve their food problems, but they have also gained income from selling excess grain, significantly improving their living standards. Although many families in Burundi have not yet fully achieved food self-sufficiency, according to current progress, it is expected that in the next 3 years, Burundi's rice hybridization rate will reach 70%, basically achieving food self-sufficiency for the entire country. It is expected that by 2029, the hybrid rice planting area in Burundi will expand to 100,000 hectares. By then, hunger and poverty will not be a problem in this country. In fact, rice is one of the major food crops in the world, and about 60% of the global population depends on it. However, the hybrid rice technology developed by China has been adopted and applied by more than 20 African countries. Apart from Burundi, Madagascar has become the African country with the largest planting area and highest yield of hybrid rice. This is enough to prove that China's hybrid rice is taking root and growing vigorously in African countries, bearing tangible fruits. This also solves the problem of feeding more people in Africa to a certain extent. To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.